Welcome to Electricity Sound, Economics of Capital Market. Today, we are going to discuss about the participants in primary market. Next important participant in primary market is the share transfer agent. In this section, the functions of share transfer agent as a participant of primary market are given. Next important participants in the primary market is share transfer agent. A share transfer agent is an agent who, on behalf of the body corporates, maintain records of holders of security issued by such body corporates and deals with the process of transfer and redemption of securities. That is, the important functions of transfer agent is that they maintain records of holders of security. Then the other one is the process of transfer as well as the redemption of securities. The agent or the participants who do these types of activities are termed as share transfer agents. As per SEBI guideline, certain role must only be performed by a share agent. These activities are endorsement of certificates for allotment or call money, transmission, consolidation or subdivision of securities, dispatch of transfer securities and securities received for transmission, consolidation, subdivision, etc. directly to the investors, cancel the name and certificates of shareholders who had sold the shares of security and replace it with new shareholders. These activities must be done by the share transfer agent only, that is endorsement of certificate, transmission, consolidation, subdivision of securities, dispatch of transfer securities, cancellation of the name as well as the replacing of the names with the new shareholders. These responsibilities are to be done by the share transfer agents only. Therefore, the major functions of the share transfer agents includes maintaining records of the shareholders of the security of the company for and on behalf of the company, handling of all matters related to the transfer and redemption of securities, functioning as depository participants, then with the setting up of the depository and the expansion of network of depositories, the traditional work of registrar is likely to undergo. These are the important functions of the share transfer agent. Next important participants in the primary market is the debenture trustees. We know that debenture is an instrument of debt issued by the company for acknowledging its obligation to repay the sum along with the interest. That is, it is an acknowledgement of the obligations by the company to repay the sum along with the interest in the future. In the case of the public issue of debentures, there would be a large number of debenture holders on the register of the company. It is not possible for, as it shall not be feasible to create charge in favor of each debenture holders, a common methodology generally adopted is the creation of trust deed, which conveys the property of the company. A trust deed is an arrangement enabling the property to be held by a person or persons for the benefit of some other persons known as beneficiary, and it has been made mandatory for any company making public or right issue of the debentures to appoint one or more debenture trustees before issuing the prospectus or letter of offer. The trustees who are appointed to safeguard the interest of the debenture holders are called debenture trustees. Be appointed before the issue of debentures by the company, they need to obtain a certificate of registration from the SEBI as per the SEBI Debenture and Trustee Rules and Regulation Act 19. The debenture trustee is a liaison between the issuer company and the debenture holders. Hold the secured property on behalf of the issuer company, which is mortgaged in favor of the debenture trustees for protecting the interest of debenture holders. A debenture is an instrument of debt exhibited by the company acknowledging its obligation to repay the sum at a specified rate and also carrying an interest. This is one of the methods of raising loan capital of the company. A debenture trustee means a trustee of the trust deeds. A debenture trustee means a trustee of the trust deeds securing any issue of debentures of a corporate body. That is, the debenture trustee means those who are appointed to safeguard the interest of debenture holders are called debenture trustee, and they safeguard interest of the investors in the debenture scheme. Debentures. The eligibility of a debenture trustee are a scheduled bank carrying on commercial activity, an insurance company, or a body. Corporates can act as a debenture trustee. And it is mandatory for any company making public or right issue of debentures to appoint one or more debenture trustee before issuing the prospectus. Major duties of the debenture trustees include for periodical reports from body corporates or issuer of debentures, take possession of trust property in accordance with the provision of trust deed, enforce security in the interest of debenture holders, ensure on a continuous basis that property charged to the debenture is available and adequate at all times to discharge the interest and principal amount payable in respect of the debentures. Such property is free from any other encumbrance except those which are specifically agreed with the debenture trustees. That is, they must ensure that the property charged to the debenture is available and adequate. Another duty is exercise due diligence to ensure compliance by the body corporates with the provision of the Companies Act, the listing agreement of the stock exchanges, or the trust deeds. These duties are performed by the debenture trustees, and it is mandatory for the companies to appoint debenture trustees if they are issuing public or the right issue of debentures, and they must be appointed before the issue of debentures. Another type of participants is the portfolio managers. They must be registered with the SEBI as per the SEBI Portfolio Manager Rules and Regulation Act 1993. And a portfolio manager is a body corporate who, pursuant to a contract or agreement with a client, advises or directs or undertakes on behalf of clients, whether as a discretionary portfolio manager or otherwise, the management or administration of portfolios, securities, or funds of the clients. That is, they undertake the responsibility of the administration and management of portfolio of securities. The discretionary portfolio manager individually and independently manages the funds of each clients in accordance with the needs of clients. And another type is non-discretionary portfolio manager. They manages the funds in accordance with the directions of the clients. Discretionary portfolio manager means the individual and independently manages the funds of each clients and in accordance with the needs of the clients. Here, non-discretionary manager manages the funds in accordance with the directions of the clients. These are the functions that is they look after the portfolio of securities. Required to keep a minimum net worth of the portfolio manager is required to have a minimum net worth of rupees 2 crores. The registered portfolio manager exclusively carry on portfolio management. Merchant bankers in category 1 and 2 can also act as portfolio manager with the prior permission from the SEBI. These are the functions performed by, that is, here the portfolio manager look after the portfolios of the securities, and they need a minimum net worth of 2 crores for functioning as a portfolio.